So I went and looked up that William Kingdon Clifford quote from the previous episode about the ship owner moving out there. Apparently that was a parable. He wasn't actually referring to anything that literally happened. But it's interesting, the sentence that that essay apparently ends with is this. "It is wrong always, everywhere, and for anyone to believe anything upon insufficient evidence." Take that as you will, and apply it where you see fit. Oh, well, now I almost don't want to upset this, so I'll carefully follow my path and get more oil on my shoes. So, even in spite of our careful treadings, our careful walks, I don't think this place is very wheelchair accessible. That's a bit of a pity. So, we need more information. Maybe we can go get some more. These Tetris blocks have really been bothering me for a long time now. Oh, maybe we can... okay, that one is open. We can just go right in there. The other hedge mazes do seem to be blocked off, but maybe today this is what we'll investigate. Alright. It's a hedge maze. I don't know what else to tell you. Thankfully, this is one of those ones that's just armpit height, so you can still see what you're doing. I'm not even going to try and employ the right-hand rule here. Oh. Okay. I think I see what the joke is here. Okay. Let's keep better track of what we did. Okay. So we went left, then up three times until we made it to this junction. But not where it stops and you have to turn right. One before that. Then we go in here and down, and then around, and up and over. Okay? I think it looked like this. Yep, sure did. Intriguing. Okay, and that also opened this door. Okay, yeah, that was definitely not open before. Alright. Very well, then. I'll play your little game here. Okay, so there's multiple ways through this maze, but we need to overlay the paths upon which we can actually go from the other areas. I think it might be useful to climb up onto a balcony so we can see a better overhead view of these mazes. I think that would do us very, very well here. What would be perfect, of course, would be if we could climb up to that tower, but something, I get the kind of feeling we're not going to be allowed to go that high up until we solve these maze puzzles to begin with. There's going to be that kind of circular logic involved with this whole thing. So yeah, there's probably only one way up into the tower. That guy's going to keep an eye on things, and our job is not quite going to be that simple. Still, though, let's do what we can. We'll at least get this much. Sure, I could sketch all this out, but I don't need to. I have something better. I have computer adaptability. There we go. Truly, our transhumanist future will certainly involve, integrated camera support. All right. So I guess the way to think about this is to kind of think of the base of this as like a 5x5 grid with the holes occurring at various intervals. And this is, in fact, in the upper right. So yeah, actually, what is preventing me from just picking the path where it goes all the way up and all the way over? Is it really that simple? Could it truly be just like that? No, of course not. Are there hexagons I need to be aware of? Are there areas over which the path must travel? Or am I looking at things from the wrong perspective? Starting from there, what's the correct path through? Are there, in fact, multiple paths? Is this actually about the right-hand rule? No. Am I looking for a discrepancy between what's this map of the maze and what the maze actually looks like? Yeah, that's an L-shaped wall. This is a vertical wall that's shaped like that, and that's a horizontal wall that's shaped like that. Yeah. Yeah, there's definitely a discrepancy at the very least. Like, I think this is all equal. That kind of L-shaped bit there. But yeah, this path should be clear. It should be possible to just go all along this area. Go straight up to the left, and then straight up over. So there has to be a logical reason. Maybe this grass is important somehow? Don't step on the grass? Is that what I'm being asked to do? Don't step on the grass. Well, let's first see if that's even possible. I could believe that. Go here. This whole thing is a dead end. I mean, it's an environmental piece of clue. It's a clue. I'll try and follow it. Go here. I could go around, but this... Yeah, that's grass, so I'd have to go around and like that. Okay. Let's keep that in mind, then. Fair enough. Okay, so we have access to this balcony now. We didn't have that before. I guess that's like a... Ooh. Oh dear. Was somebody trying to hide in there? Or is that a coincidence? No, that is not a coincidence. Is this? Is this like a bathtub or a sink or something? No, it's some sort of hauling device, I think. Ugh, man. Okay, so this is where we can come if we want an aerial view. Here's a spot where we can actually see... Wait, what's in that tree? Like the one that's this. What's this? I can't quite tell. And anyway, that's the gate puzzle down there. It's obviously I don't quite have the high enough resolution to quite see what's going on there, but I get the impression somebody's trying to set up some kind of shadow theater going on here. Or maybe I'm just seeing things. That's entirely possible. Let's take a nice good overview look. Like, this is a pretty simple layout. Like, it's not even a maze at this point. What we have to do is note that this is, again, different. Oh, you have got to be kidding me. I don't think they're kidding, folks. You're gonna have to use all your senses to beat this game, not just sight. I wonder what you do if you're deaf. Can you still beat this game even if you're deaf? Because the subtitles are certainly no help here. Guess you'll just have to recruit a friend for this puzzle. You might not even realize what's going on. Okay, from here, go here, 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 here. And like that. Got that? No? Well, that's all right. Let's trace that out one more time. So, here, turn right immediately. Right. Up. Right. No. Up. Up. Hit the wall. Go right. Up. Go right. Go down, hit the wall, go down and up. Okay. Well, I did watch Alex Diner's excellent Let's Play of Sensorium, a game that took a lot of inspiration from this The Witness puzzle game, so I understand. So, unfortunately my computer is not equipped with smell-o-vision yet. We will not be licking our monitor. Okay, well we can already see that again there's some discrepancies between this area's shape and what is actually on the map, so maybe we are intended to draw something that makes sense in the real world as well as on this. So we have to turn right. You can't go up here. In fact, yeah, actually, being able to see this from here is actually a big help. I appreciate that. Now we can really see why this is all waist height. So here, can't go up. We'll need to go over, up like that, over, Can't go up here. Can't go left there, so this is all wrong, so don't go this way at all. Backtrack to here. So over here. Up. Over right. Up. Left. Straight up. And then here. Okay, just a repetition of the theme that we had earlier, but a little bit trickier. I'm glad I was able to kind of mentally trace that out on the map as I was walking it. I appreciate that. And that's how we get over here. But first, a new area of the balcony. Oh boy, scenic view. And there's also this. We can get into the central shaft. We can climb the tower. Oh, of course. Of course. Well, were you paying attention to how you were able to well, hold on. What's this do? Nothing. So, I think we were supposed to, yeah, now we've got to input all four of our paths and then, like, stop here, maybe? Okay. Hope you remembered what order those were in. I don't. They're gonna have to be rotated accordingly. Well, at least here we can see, so. But we can't see all four of them at the same time. Alright, I will probably just leave that for another episode, just because, again, I'm gonna have to refer to notes and screenshots and whatnot to do that properly. I think you understand what is being asked for here, but, I don't really find this puzzle quite as interesting as some of the other ones. What I do find interesting is that they're all different colors. And then what's this? I guess this gets powered on when we solve that other puzzle. And then, interestingly enough, it looks like the projector comes out the bottom of this one. This is an upside-down crate. I guess it would have to go through the window here, but it looks like it's got a line of sight. Okay, leaving that aside, what can we do over here? Do we have access to another courtyard pressure plate puzzle? Is this the right angle to be coming at things from? Or is this just under construction? Ah, security detail. Yeah, maybe this was a resort town. I don't see any obvious way in over here, hold on, except that we have this, which does not actually directly seem related to the puzzle itself. Seems to just be disconnected. Maybe it opens the door, though. Well, I guess if we didn't know we could do things at long range, we'll certainly know now. Okay, that's important. Come again, though? Okay. So that counts for up. Surely it's done something, but I can't quite put my finger on it yet. Doesn't seem to be activating any wires. Yeah, how do we get down there? Good question. I just don't see any stairways here, so I guess we have to get here from the lower, like maybe from ground level somewhere else. So yeah, this is already elevated, so I guess we have to just exit the castle entirely then, because this is ground level down here, so maybe we get to that courtyard from circling around this to the outside. I could certainly believe that. That'd be in character for what this game is all about. Yeah, wasn't there like another... Yeah, there was an external door around here somewhere. Yeah, this one. I want to open this door. That's... I think that's our way into the courtyard. At least doing something interesting. But, well, I think we're gonna have to open it from the other side. That is just what we have been stuck with. We can't otherwise circle around the castle. There's no other way we can get at... We can't climb, sneak our way up through here. That will not be allowed. And all of that is solid, and if we go down here... I think we were inside that building at some point. Were we? Maybe when... I think it's through the gate. The slidey door. And it was over here. No, this was the building we were inside. We've never been inside that other one. Down farther. Yeah, that's the building. We've never been here, I think. This looks new. Well, it looks like some sort of delivery channel. And we can fast travel here if we want. I don't know if that was unlocked before, but we've certainly unlocked it now. Wait, but if this is, if water level is down here, then how do things get loaded up here? Wouldn't you want, like, a dock to be, yeah, at water level? Oh boy, things just keep getting stranger and stranger. Just don't know what to make of this anymore. No. That's wrong. Something's weird about these sun-shaped elements. They are not dots. They are suns, or mines. But I'm gonna say suns. So there's that down there whenever I feel like I want to play around with it, and then there's this up here whenever I feel like I want to play with that, but it's got both the jack and the... and all that stuff, so who knows. It's all Greek to me. I don't think we were ever down here. I think we were climbing around on top of that building earlier, but I don't think we were at this exact spot yet before. This does look like it's the other side of that door, so I guess this is just a hint saying that we want to know about both of those things before we go here, but it won't necessarily actually stop you from going here if you find another way around. But, yeah, my suspicions are confirmed. This was absolutely a quarry. A quarry that they carved a building into. And this looks like an incinerator, maybe? Or a kiln? Yeah, this looks like a kiln. For making bricks with, perhaps. And like the rest of the island, it has seen better days. Also, this, I guess, is like a fire exit or something, because this looks more like an exit than an entrance. Certainly doesn't have a handle for me to pull that door with. Ooh, boy. Okay. That looks intimidating, but nonetheless maybe still workable. This at least looks more like a loading zone than everything else you've seen. Maybe this is like a reservoir or something. Hard to tell. But, I might not know how it all works yet, but maybe if I find some more information, I can work it out. But clearly they were using this to build something else, but the castles are already there. They're not made of these bricks, so it raises the question of why all of this was necessary. Okay, it's not a reflection puzzle, it's just two spots we can start with. Well, this just raises further questions. Were they making concrete in here? Well, okay, guess we need more power. Okay. Now, where's this light coming from? This looks really suspicious. This looks suspicious as all get out. Okay, so I guess that's what these are, is a method of remotely activating one dot. Cover all the hexagons except one for each of the symbols. how's this going to work? Okay, so this is the most valuable one. This will tell us whether it can activate when it's in the same region or not. No, it can't. So therefore, we want it to be adjacent like so. This one has no jack in it at all, though. And this one does, of course. Alright, I think that's the elevator control panel there. We'll want to be on it. Okay, we're learning. There is, once again, a correspondence between reality and what is depicted. Oh man, even the birds too. I guess it makes sense if the dog was affected, then so would the birds, but... Where are all the other birds then? Wouldn't there be a ton of birds in the forest, or were they all scared away by people walking and working around there? Pigeons certainly wouldn't be scared of people. That makes sense. That makes sense why they're there. But where's all the other stuff? Where's the rabbits and the foxes and all that stuff?
What is divine in man is elusive and impalpable, and he is easily tempted to embody it in a concrete form, a church, a country, a social system, a leader, so that he may realize it with less effort and serve it with more profit. Yet, the attempt to externalize the kingdom of heaven in a temporal shape must end in disaster. It cannot be created by charters or constitutions, nor established by arms. Those who seek for it alone will reach it together, and those who seek it in company will perish by themselves. Hugh Kingsmill, 1944.
Oh, hold on. That's not what this looked like beforehand. So are those mutually exclusive, then? One raises, the other lowers. Yep, that's... the same thing happened down there, too. That's linked. And so is that. I'm on to something here. I know I am, game. But not enough. Not enough so. Oh. Huh. So I guess that's where the light is coming from, then. So it's special down here, but it's not special up there. Go figure. Well, maybe we need to do more of these puzzles first. So we can control both of those from down here. I can just barely, faintly see the blue outline of the jack shape right up there, so we can still see that there is one there. Can't see that covered hexagon, though. Okay, so it fixes one mistake, perhaps? So it fixes one discrepancy, perhaps. These are very helpful. These help me figure out the rules. Okay, so let's see how many of these divisions we can make all at once, and then we can decide which of these is the odd factor out. It's probably going to be either this one or this one. So let's work under that assumption that these need to be divided. Oh, and these do. Okay, so... I know I'm not making it to the end, so something like that, but different. Well, that's no good. Maybe we include that, exclude these. Yeah, this is tricky. This is very tricky. Remind me what it looks like when it's like that. No, it will convert one, but the others are still problems. Okay? Makes sense. Close, but no, that's good enough. Okay. All right, I'll take it. And maybe now this time. Yeah, I'm not sure how to mathematically formalize this one. Do we want this to be in a region of all greens with one red, or do we want it to be in a region with all reds with one green? So this is a huge problem, this area. We need, like, all four of these to be active, so one of these needs to be converted. I just don't know which one yet. But that's a problem. So these, everything that's not involved in this has to actually stand. So this is part of the solution, and this is part of the solution, and this is part of the solution. The trouble is that a lot of other things are also part of the solution. Okay, so I feel like we're starting to get somewhere, but at the same time, I also feel like I'm chasing, like, loose ends that are just not going to work out properly. So we need to separate out more of this. So, yeah, we'll have to divide this up into individual regions that are all either one color, like that one down there that I just isolated, or the big one that is probably going to have one discrepancy in it, but is otherwise fine. That seems to have done it. Okay, there we go. Finally. Okay, so one of these... Okay, yeah. So one of these is allowed to be not included, but we couldn't have done the equivalent of this we saw earlier in the game that had, a lot of divisions in it. So this should work. And finally... We'll include one of these, but otherwise we will actually divide this correctly. There we go. Alright, what has that gained us? This, which perhaps affects the functionality of this. Maybe this is a lockout mechanism. So now this might be fixing either a discrepancy with the colors I'm dividing, or it could fix a discrepancy in the hexagons I'm using. Fascinating. So yeah, there's a lot of these. I might as well get all of them. Let's see what happens here. This is probably going to result in multiple discrepancies, right? Yeah, all of those. However, this would only be one discrepancy. That not being covered. That gets fixed, and otherwise everything is okay. Now what did we just turn on? These are probably questions I should be asking myself more often than... Oh, goodness. Who did this? Who threaded a wire through a grate or, like, an air vent like that? Who does that? Is it even the same person who's laying out all these wires beforehand? Also, I cannot get down from here unless I engage the elevator. It does not seem like there is an alternate way down, I think. Not unless I solve this, which I probably can, right? Like, we just do this and make stairs? Yeah, okay. I understand. So if I understand the simple things, why can't I understand the complicated things? Is it because I don't have enough context yet? Or is it because there's something else I just haven't found yet? The simple thing that untangles all of this. The wire is going out through the roof. I need to get to the roof. I'm pretty sure we were on the roof earlier. We're not going to get to it from here, but we could get to it from out there. I do want to trace that lead before we call it a day. We've merely done one element of our job here. We still want to get up here. There we go. Neat environment. It looks so big at the start, but I'm starting to feel my way around it now. Yeah, I want to get up there. There's... On the other side of that roof, there should be a wire that's white now. We've solved this. We still don't know what the deal is with this yet. Haven't learned what Tetris blocks are about yet. I feel like I understand now what jacks are about. Let's go to the top of the quarry and get on top of the roof of the, concrete plant, for lack of a better word. Oh, that's, well, we know we want to start working with this object. Alright, we've got to find where that wire comes from, then. And that comes from downstairs, it would seem. It's not that wire, it's this one from way across down in that plant. So we've got to solve everything in there before we can activate the beacon. I think that's it. Wait, is that the same wire, though? No, this looks like maybe it's a different one. What's it doing? It's activated the computer on that lift. Okay, I think we are actually clear to use this to go to, individual floors? No, just up and down. Now, the important question is there a call button for the elevator? Also, that should have gone down? Yes, we are going down now. Okay. Well, in case you want to haul a giant pallet of bricks all the way to the top, you can do that. But yeah, I don't think there is a call button for this. This has an operator. Okay, so the bottom port provides power to the bottom part of the motor, and the motor makes it go down. That's the correct metaphor for how this works. So if we want the second part of the power to that yellow cube, we must solve the puzzles that correspond to this wire. And thus, we must understand what is going on in this hauling area for... It doesn't quite look like a sawmill, it looks like something else. I'll probably get a better idea of what's going on in here once I've actually done a thing or two in here. But I still just don't quite feel like I get what's going on here. So... maybe we'll just come back. Alright, well, I think that is enough for today. It is very late. I've done plenty of exploring and solving. I've got myself orientated a little bit better, but in some ways I'm still lost. Still, I think I have a good idea of how to find things. It's just going to take some work to find them. So, I will see you some other time.